तुम्हें ऑब्जेक्टिव पता चल गया आरटीआई किस लिए है, ठीक है, यू हैव कम टू नो व्हाट आरटीआई इज फॉर, इट सो दैट इट ब्रिंग्स, आई मीन फॉर व्हाट इट इज, टू ब्रिंग ट्रांसपेरेंसी ऑफ ऑल दैट थिंग्स, बट राइट आरटीआई व्हाट इज द फुल फॉर्म, जस्ट कैन यू टेल मी एनीवन, राइट, इन दैट व्हाट डज इंफॉर्मेशन मीन, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन, टुमारो यू विल कम एंड यू विल फाइल एन आरटीआई, यू विल टेल, यू टेल, टेल मी द पासवर्ड ऑफ योर बैंक अकाउंट, I mean that is also kind of information. You can't ask for any information. There are some limits for information. And what kind of information you can ask for? Here comes. Information is any material, any form. Fine. You know that information. You can even my passwords, my property, everything. That is, everything in return, it's all information. But what you can ask for? Okay. It includes records, documents, memos, emails, opinion, reasons, circles, everywhere. Fine. Models, data that are held in electronic form. Look, this is more important. Data that are held in any electronic form. So, it's not that RTA you can file for only, I mean, documentation, I mean, the papers, what is that, hard copies. Even soft copy comes in that, right? So, right to information, fine. The information there, it includes that, this, what is that, data material in electronic form, any material in electronic form. Comes under this information, fine. Then logbook, contracts, reports, paper samples, they do any private body which is access to public authority under law, fine. So private or ya public, okay. Let it be anything. But all your logbooks, contracts, reports, papers, sample models, ये सब information है. And right to information किसको है, ठीक है. For example, you are a private organization, suppose, fine. तुम्हारे जो कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स है, ठीक है, दैट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स गवर्नमेंट हैज अ राइट, यू कांट हाइड दोस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स फॉर गवर्नमेंट, गवर्नमेंट हैज अ राइट टू इंफॉर्मेशन दैट दे शुड नो अबाउट द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स, ओके, देयर आर सम लिमिटेशंस, ओके, जे यू जस्ट सीन नेक्स्ट स्लाइड्स, देयर आर सम लिमिटेशन, बट या सम थिंग्स लाइक अदर पीपल लाइक मी लाइक यू, यू डोंट हैव एनी एक्सेस टू दोस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स, दे आर नॉट इंफॉर्मेशन फॉर यू, बट दैट इज इंफॉर्मेशन फॉर गवर्नमेंट, सो दिस इज अ बिट कॉम्प्लेक्स प्रोजेक्ट, बट दिस टेक अ सुपरफिशियल व्यू ऑफ दिस. So in future you may be. Now, as I told first, look, RTA is for public authority. I mean, look, any public or you can take information from any public authority. Fine, private to you know, ठीक है, private to whatever I, you, individual owns or a group of them owns, that comes, which is non-government, that is private. But public authority, what is public authority? Look. A self-government, institution of self-government established or constituted or under by the constitution, fine, that comes, then look, financed by the central government or a state government, that's more important. A public authority is self-government establishment, fine, that is financed by self-government or state government, that comes under public authority, fine, you can't say anything, like suppose there is a garden, okay, fine, there is a garden. Maybe some suppose you live in a colony, there is a garden, fine, and that garden is not actually you are not getting any funds for that garden to make it. You people of the colony, fine, you contribute from your pocket, you contribute per year, you maintain the garden, fine. That though that is public in the colony, I mean anyone can from the colony can access it, but that doesn't become a public property, nor a public authority. I mean you can't ask any contracts or thing about the garden. You can't, you don't have any access to that information. Why? Because that is not financed by central government or state government. Simple. So public, I mean, even you, someone can say, okay, garden comes under this thing. I have information to see where I will utilize the funds. Tomorrow, someone from other colony, might raise a question. I have some problem. So I want to know where have you utilized the funds. They can't. Why? That is not a public authority. You can only apply this act to public authority. And that is not public authority because it's not financed by central or state government. Well, now fees for seekers, as I told, fine, there are fees. Now there are many things, fine. There are different things. If you are sending by, if you want a hard copy, if you want a CD, okay, if you want an electronic document page in A4 size, suppose some mark sheet of yours, which is just one simple A4 size paper, fine. You want to file it for RTI exam, you hardly it will cost you some 2 to 5 rupees. I mean, everything can be done in minimum 20, 25 if it's very big document or something. So this why the basic need for this is also, that's why they told it's benefit for poor and underprivileged. Why? Because they can spare actually 2 rupees. Now the case is different. I mean, when the law was made, now people in politics, they say you can have your lunch in 12 rupees and you can eat food in 10 rupees and there goes on discussion on, fine. So that's different now. There come changes. That is law, that is politics. But as far as the written laws are concerned, okay, constitution is concerned, fine, the charges are very less, as you can see, 2 rupees, 4 rupees, so any one of you, anywhere, if you want some information, you want to file some RTI, fine, that's the only cost, it's not something very costly. So, it becomes easy, so transparency becomes more possible, more transparency, more good things happen. In form of application, now you have to write an application for it. You can't just go to anyone and you tell, under RTI I have this right to know, just tell me what is it. It's not oral thing. First you have to write an application form, fine. And that application, then again, there is no prescribed format basically. There is no prescribed format, you can write application on your own, but fine. There are some things like a postal address of the applicant, again that comes, fine. Maybe you live in same entity, fine, and you want to find an RTI here itself. But still you need to give a postal address of yours and all, some legal things are there, so you need to mention that. You can read it fast, as I've mentioned there. Fine. Again, now the next question comes. You file an RTI. You file an RTI. It's not a court case which goes on for years and years. You file an RTI today, like court cases go on for years. You do a court case today, fine. But for years and years and you don't get any result. RTI is not there. There is a time period for supply of information. Keep in mind. So no one, when there is a specific time period, of course, there is some very big document or contract has to be submitted to you, they can't do it in one day. They need some time. But fine, it's not like some, they'll take years and years for it. Fine. Usko saal and saal, saalo saal nahi lenge wo document aapko dene ke liye. Aapko kuch chand din hote hain unke paas, jaise depending upon the amount of information, it's like 48 hours ke within jo hai, ya 30 days, theek hai? Depending upon the information, uske basis pe jo hai, tumhe unko information, they have to submit you information. And that's what, ye jo law hai, again, there are loopholes. Agar bas RTI bana dete, and if they didn't make this time period of to supply of information, log saalo saal, bas wo bhi ek court case ki tarah masla ban jata. Fine. Again, if you make RTI, but you increase the fees, again, that becomes a loophole. Poor people can't get benefited from it. So these laws, as we see in news, you tell why doesn't this bill comes, Lokpal comes, this, that. Fine, it looks very easy. But you have to search for loopholes in it. And one loophole also can make the full law, full effort. It makes everything effortless. Fine, thank you. This was about the RTI campaign. We just wanted to make you aware, superficially basically. This was not too much detail. If you go in legal terms and all, there are many things, of course. But yeah. Now you are above people. There are people who know what is RTI. Before coming here, you too knew what was RTI. Fine, but if you are more interested, you can even go visit websites. There are official websites, Indian websites, where you can file. There is complaint, consumer complaints and all. Again, things like they are also there. Right? But fine, superficially when you came here, you knew only RTI as right to information. But now what you know is there are various things in under it. There is time period, there is application, fine, there is the fee for it is less. Again, public authority, where can you apply, fine, so superficially you know how, you have a guideline now, fine. Now anywhere in future, you need to file an RTI, you know the guideline, yes, application has no format, so no one can fool you. So you feel, where should I trust for, you know now, fine, all things are taken from trusted sources, Wikipedia, and we have many Indian government law sites are there, fine, this all is taken from the trusted source, so you can trust this basically. And you can in future, whenever you want to apply and file for an RTI, of course you can do. Thank you.